Hello everyone, today we're taking a look at Apter, another macro virus that actually requires us to use Windows 3.1 because I need Word version 6.0. So we'll go ahead and open up our infected Word document here, take a look at the macros. We got Apter, auto close, and auto open, and these actually infect the global template, and we can actually edit this and look at the source code very freely. And just kind of scroll through, and eventually we will see that it will delete files if this string equals 20. So I guess we'd better figure out where this string is held. So if we look in our Windows directory, there's actually a file here, winword6.ini, and this is the file that requires me to use Word 6.0. If we open it up, we've got just a bunch of, generic defaults and just path variables and stuff. But then we see that the virus has added NTTHNTA and set it equal to 1. And every time you open a Word document, close it, whatever, it will increment this counter. And when it finally reaches 20, it will activate and delete those files that we saw, which includes .com and .exe files in the C:/doc directory. Not sure if that's a typo for DOS, but that's what it says. And it also deletes fonts from the Windows/system folder and exe files from Windows. So we'll go ahead and up this to 19. Oh, it might help if I have numlock on, so we don't just go all over the place. No, 19. All right, and we will save. All right, we've incremented the counter, so now we're good to open our Word document. We should see it destroy everything. Ooh, path file access error. Sounds good. So it sounds like it's trying to do something. We've got the hourglass of doom. Okay, there we go. Seem like we're good to go. We'll exit out of here. And we are missing all the exe files from here. There are no more exes in our Windows folder. Our doc folder did have some dummy exes, but those are gone too as they got deleted. And let's see, if we minimize this, I've seen some pretty good results trying to run the exes that used to exist but no longer do. Control cannot find, clipboard viewer cannot find, Windows setup is doing something. It ran, but it didn't error out. Oh no, what's happening? Well, we got this nice, can't find write. Can we run Word? Okay, Word works. Exit out of there. How about Excel? See, this is weird because when I was testing this before, I was getting all sorts of weird memory errors and stuff running these programs. So Office is still working just fine. However, if we exit out of this, we can see that an unholy just wrath of this virus has been unleashed because Minesweeper and Solitaire are both gone, which is just unforgivable. And of course, if we go ahead and exit out of here, we can exit Windows. Oh no, we are extremely low on memory. Close an application and try again. Oh no, we're not running anything. So memory is so low, we cannot close Windows. That is, oh, okay, here we go. Now Office is broken. Application error, call to undefined Dynalink. Sick. All right, Excel still works. You can get your spreadsheet on. How about the dialogue editor? We're good. We're working. Lex out of there. PowerPoint? Sorry, available memory or system resources are insufficient. Uh-oh. This is sounding worse and worse. Excel still works. Okay. Word? Nope. Word's still broken. Viewer works. We're working. I don't understand what's happening here. Okay, Word suddenly works again. Okay, so we got a general protection fault in PowerPoint. I think this system is pretty well boned, so let's go ahead and just exit out of Windows. Oh yeah, I forgot we can't. Let's just go ahead and force restart. Alright, so we can see Windows no longer works. We can use DOS, since it didn't actually delete the right directory. It deleted C:/doc, which it successfully did, but did not touch our DOS directory, so we can still use DOS as normal. So, in order to use Windows again, you just have to reinstall it. But that is about it for the Apter Windows macro virus. Thank you for watching. Take care.